Have you ever wondered what's that star prefix for NGF and NG4? That's called a structural directive. In this video, I'll show you what it is, when you would want it, and how it works. I'll also do a part 2, showing you how to create your own structural directives. Let's start defining what it is. A structural directive is a directive with a structure. The structure is an NG template. When you write that, you're telling Angular to declare the structure and render it. But when you wrap it in an NG template, you're telling Angular to declare the structure. Notice that now we're not telling Angular to render it. Now, put a directive in the NG template and you have a structural directive. That's how NGF works. Angular parses the NG template, generating a template reference, which is injected in the NGF directive. If the condition passed to NGF is true, the template gets rendered. But it would be very annoying to create an NG template every time we wanted to use NGF or any other directive that requires an NG template. So the Angular team created a synthetic sugar, like a shortcut. When you prefix your directive with a star, Angular wraps it in an NG template and applies the directive to the NG template. So a div with star NGF becomes an NG template with NGF containing the div. It's just synthetic sugar. You could write your whole app without the star prefix if you wanted. Knowing how it works, you can now understand why we can only use one structural directive per element. If you were to use star NGF and star NG4 in the same element, how would Angular desugar that? NGF first and then NG4? The reverse? Both in the same template? Talking about NG4, it seems a lot more complicated than NGF, right? I've seen some really complex NG4 expressions, like passing a track by function, piping an observable array, grabbing the index and checking if it's the last element. Initially, I thought that was an NG4 specific lingo, but it's not. It's a fully documented syntax that works for any structural directives, even ones that you end up creating. It's called the structural directive microsyntax. Kinda obvious. The structural directive microsyntax divides expressions by semicolons. In our NG4 example, we would have 4 expressions. Expressions starting with let are variable declarations. You declare the variable name right after let and use the equal sign to point it to the name of the variable in the exported directive context. I know, that was a lot. What I mean is that when we render an NG template, we can optionally pass a context object. And the properties of this context object are passed to the template. The context object can have multiple explicit variables and a single implicit variable. It's like a JavaScript function. We have the parameters, which we declare and thus are very explicit, and we have this, which is an implicit variable that exists even though we haven't declared it. In a function, you can have as many parameters as you want, but only one this. Just like that, in an NG template, you can have as many explicit variables as you want, but only one implicit variable. The implicit variable is what you get when you don't point to any exported variable. Let item, for example, is getting the implicit variable. But let is last equals last is getting the explicit last variable. And let item index equals index is getting the explicit index variable. After desugaring the variables, that's what we get. Expressions with 2 arguments and an optional column between them are key expressions. The expression in the right gets assigned to the key in the left with a prefix before it. Let's look at some examples. In star NGF condition else other template, for the else other template expression, NGF is the prefix, else is the key, other template is the expression. That gets desugared to an NG template with the NGFElse directive pointing to other template. In star NG4 let item of list, track by track function, For the track by function expression, ng4 is the prefix, track by is the key, track by function is the expression. That gets desugared to an ng template with the ng4 track by directive pointing to track by function. Also, in that ng4 example, off list in let item off list is also a key expression. ng4 is the prefix, off is the key, list is the expression. That gets desugared to an ng template with the ng4 off directive pointing to list. The last thing to mention is the optional as keyword at the end of the expression. It declares a template variable and maps the result of the expression to it. Star ngif condition as value becomes an ng template with the ngif directive pointing to condition and let value pointing to ngif. That's it. You now understand how structural directives work and how to analyze their microsyntax. I'll do another video on how to code a custom structural directive from scratch and how to tell the Angular compiler to type check its context. Until then, have a great day and I'll see you soon.